What's up, family? Welcome back to the channel. As you guys remembered with the previous video, we have installed our bucket seats as well as with our safety point harness, and then as well our lovely roll cage that have been installed, well, built by TNT Middelburg. So from the inside, we still have a few touch-ups that we need to do before we are finished with it. Obviously we still need to paint it, but yeah, for now we're going to install our new, well, not new gauges, it's just the gauges that come out of the Nissan. It's a voltmeter, oil pressure, and then as well as a wideband or a AFR gauge. And then we've bought this lovely A-pillar gauge port that we're gonna use for our BMW. Install it here nicely on the side, on the A-pillar. And I'm really super stoked about that, to get that up. So we're gonna try and install those three gauges today, and then then we are basically almost done with the inside. Then we still have to do our steering wheel as well as our handbrake, and then as soon as that's done, then we are basically finished with the interior. Then we can remove everything again and then paint it inside and install everything. Then we are done. Then we can move to the engine. We're probably going to do the engine in between as well, as we receive our parts. We're obviously going to do the engine bay, but for now, like I said, we're doing what we've got with the parts that we've got, so we're going to do the install the gauge port now. Before we continue, guys, please do not forget to like this video. It would really assist me, and then as well, do not forget to subscribe so that you can follow us on our drift build BMW E46. Let's gonna have some fun. Okay, so firstly, we've got our nice gauge board that we're gonna use. So it's basically gonna sit like this. Sit like this inside the BMW, so that we can see all our necessary gauge. I still need a boost gauge, but I'll probably get a boost gauge once we go over to turbo. So for now, running aspirated, I believe this is for me the most important gauges that we need to run, as the other ones we already have it, water temp, we have it, fuel level, we have it, rev, and then obviously we have our speedo as well. So we're gonna start with this, just put the gauges in. Probably gonna start with my volt gauge. I think I must maybe leave it here at the bottom, because the voltmeter itself is not too important. It's just to see if the battery is charging or not. So I'll just be putting this wiring. Remember, this wiring gauges we used previously in the Nissan. So it has been used before. It's not brand new. So yeah, we've got our voltmeter in, and just push it through. There we go. We'll just twist and turn it once it's inside, so that we can have it nice, level, and straight. Then next, I'm definitely gonna put my oil pressure on top, because this is a most common problem that we have on the BMWs. It's losing oil pressure. We're gonna upgrade the oil pump eventually, but for now, it's just nice to see where our temperatures are running to. Now we have that one in. Just push it through. There we go. Now we've got volt, and we've got our oil pressure. And now we can go over to the wideband, or the AFR as they call it as well. Take all of this out, sensors, and then probably just need to remove this back piece. And this one, you can just install it in the middle. So now it's from pretty really important oil pressure to a bit less important AFR, and then from there we're going over to our voltmeter. So now, if you look at the back, we have to connect those wires in a sequence. Black is obviously going to be your earth. Black is your earth, as well as here you've got your earth. And then luckily this gauge just doesn't need a memory, so you can just, for example, depends on what color you want. If you want it blue, you're probably going to wire red and yellow together, and then if you want red, then you're probably going to wire red and yellow together. So we'll just check on the diagram where this is going to. So I'm just going to install this plug, and then we're going to start with just wiring those three gauges together into one wiring. Alright, so just to quickly explain to you guys, here is my oil pressure. This is going to be my sensor. This is going to the sensor that's going to go all the way to the engine bay. And then you've got your black, that's your earth, and then the red and the orange one, we're going to make it together so that it makes it red. If I'm going to take this red one and I'm going to mix it with a white one here, it's going to make it blue. The same for the other three gauges as well. As you can see here, I've got red and orange together, and then once again I've got black on its own, so that's going to turn it on. And then as well, this is the earth, and then same as for the AFR gauge. Now unfortunately here we've got our white and red together, and then we've got our black earth. So in a snap of my fingers, I am going to quickly wire this into one so that I can basically just use one earth, one power, and then two remote wires, as I need a remote wire for the AFR gauge, as well as a remote wire or a sensor wire for the oil pressure as well. So let's get this done. With all the wiring, as you can see, now done, I've got now my earths has been connected inside here. I've got my positives has been connected in here. I've got my remote wiring, as well as all those three gauges wiring is connected in this whole piece. As I'm going to show you now, here at the end, you will see now I've got my positive, I've got my sensor wire, and then I've got as well as my negative. So now, technically speaking, you're going to take this whole setup as it is here right now. That actually looks red. I think it's my t-shirt. Anyway, so if you're going to take this whole setup as it is now, and then bring this wiring over here. So now, if I'm going to take these two wires, it's a positive for my earth. As soon as I connect this to the battery, all three gauges is supposed to come on simultaneously. So let's see if it works. Sorry, my bad. There we go. As you can see, all three of them are on, and it is working perfectly. So now we can take this whole setup as it is here. Then all I'm gonna do now, I'm basically just gonna mount it in here. Let me just get inside first. Here we go. So we're gonna take this whole setup as it is here, and then we're just gonna mount it there just like this, so that once you are here as I'm sitting, you can see all three gauges, this one, that one, and this one. So we're gonna mount this up, and then we're gonna continue with all of this wiring down here to see where we're gonna wire everything in. Actually quite excited. I think this is gonna look super sick. Right, so our gauge board is finally done. Here's now the wiring for to switch them on, the positive that we're going to connect to a remote wire. There at the bottom, I'll show you that now. And then as well, the black one we need to connect on the earth. So now, if we get into the car, this is approximately my height. Here you can see the gauges nice and clearly from top to bottom. We're going to put another steering wheel as well. So yeah, before we continue with those wiring, just want to move to the front quickly. And now that we are here, we need to install a new sensor for our gauge, as we're gonna run a separate oil pressure sensor. So I just bought, went to go and buy this T-piece. I just went to go and fit it. So this basically turns into the standard fitting where you're supposed to connect your oil pressure sensor for your car, for the management itself. So we're gonna turn that in all the way. And then once that's in, we're gonna connect our original sensor, T-piece that in on the top, as you can see right there. And then from there, we're gonna move over to this sensor, and then we're gonna T-piece that in right here. So from here, as you can see now, we've got a nice clean bracket, as you can see, T-piece for our sensors. So we're gonna tighten that up, and then as soon as we are done with that, we're gonna finish up with the wiring. As you can see, here's my remote wire that's supposed to go all the way to that side. I'll just extend it, and then here we've got our AFR sensor that must go to the exhaust. That's gonna connect there, and then all our gauges will be up and running. So if we get this sorted out, the oil pressure sensor with the wiring, and then we're gonna move all the way to the inside. This side now, we are all done. We just tucked some of those wiring away, but it's fine. As you can see, there goes the remote wire, well, the signal wire all the way to the sensor, and then it's well nicely connected as well. And it's nicely tucked away as soon as you've got the intake, everything on. You won't even be able to see it. So now that that's done, we're gonna come all the way in the inside. So now what we need to do, we're gonna just take the black wire, as you can see we have it here, just give that a proper ground. We can just put a lug on it and then connect it to one of those bolts there that touch the body, and then it should earth properly. And then we're gonna use a test light and test each and every one of these wires here with ignition on, just to see which wire comes on with a test light when you switch the ignition on. And then we're gonna tap into that power so that we have our remote wire for the gauges. So let's go ahead and finish up with this last piece that we've got left. Right, fam, so we are all done. We're done in the front. And then here, let me just see if we can turn a light on here. As you can see, there goes my wiring to the front, and then there goes the black wire from there all the way to that side, and then I grounded it there, and then the positive also is coming from there. As you can see, here comes the wire all the way through here, and then on this side of the ignition, here we go, I've connected it in here. I tapped it in here. So now we do have power on them, ground, earth, and our sensors are connected as well. So before, I'm going to show you what it looks like. I really want to go and head out first, switch off the lights so that we can see what it looks like at night. So here we go. Switch off the light. Oh, it's pitch black. Can only see the interior lights of the car. So what is the roof light? Okay, so I'm getting in. Here you can see the gauges. So I don't know if I can switch off the lights so long. Okay, I'm just switching this lights on so long so that everything can come on together. So I'm going to switch it off. I don't know how to switch it off. There we go. Okay, so yeah, are you guys ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, go. There we go. There you can see the gauges now. I don't know what's going on there. That's not lacquer. Maybe we should still set it. And then AFR. And then there's our voltmeter. And there's the rest of our gauges. This is the fuel level. I can probably turn this on now again. Here we go. There's the fuel level. The speed, the rev, and then the water temp. And then we have this extra gauges now installed as well. You can't really quite see it as it's nicely in the dark, especially I don't know what's going on, but yeah, it looks pretty neat. I really like it a lot. I hope just it's not going to be too much in the way when I'm driving, but we will probably find that out when I'm going to drive it. So there we go, family. We are all done with our gauge pod, a pillar gauge pod that we've installed with our three gauges, with the sensors and all of that. So yeah, we still have a lot of work left to do. We still need to start the car, drive the car as well. We still have to do the the steering wheel. We still have to do the hydraulic handbrake, and then we still need to move to the engine bay as well. So yeah, we've done quite a lot so far. If you guys watched until now, I really do appreciate it. And then if you've liked the video, please like it. And then if you haven't subscribed yet, please do not hesitate to subscribe, as we are still going to do a lot more on the car, and we are building this E46 328 as a drift car. So maybe you learned something along the way, maybe not, doesn't matter. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate it. You must have a lovely day further, and God bless. Ciao. I can fly.